I don't want to keep you too long because I know you haven't slept, because that's the that's the nature of becoming WWE champion. Nonstop media, flights across the country, and all just to tell everybody, you know, how you're feeling, what your thoughts are. I know we're still a little bit of a ways away, but WrestleMania is on the horizon. For all intents and purposes, barring any catastrophe for Bobby Lashley, you are going to defend the WWE Championship at WrestleMania.
I am.
I know that's a little bit ahead of, you know, where we are right now, but off the top of your head, give me some options. Who's standing across the ring?
Well, mine is, I want to fight Drew.
Okay.
Drew's been on a tear. And
you guys tore it up last year, right at the beginning of the pandemic. I was there in the building watching you guys beat the living hell out of each other.
Yes. And it was fun. and Drew is right there. I think Drew's right in the line, and Drew had an amazing run. Great champion. But I think I'm the man to legitimize him. He's been looking for it this entire year.
Whoa,
and that's what makes it fun. I mean, because everybody looks at us is like, man, Bobby's the champion, and man, Drew's been on a tear. Who wins this matchup?
I love it, man. I love it. You said the word legitimacy, and that was the first thing that was going through my mind last night when I saw you holding the title above your head, MVP in the ring with you, all the pomp and circumstance, and knowing how you arrived to the Thunderdome, no doubt, dressed to the nines, I went, that's a world champion. That's my world champion right there, man. I just want to take a second, personally, as your friend and as a fan, to just tell you how proud and happy I am for you and your success.
Thank you, man. I tell you, I wear it proud. When I come in, I mean, the suits and everything, that is an image of the Hurt Business, but I'm proud of everything that's going on, man. I'm happy about it. The whole Hurt Business, where I'm at right now, I'm a little older athlete, and I'm still able to compete with the young guys and do it at a very high level. I'm proud of everything that's going on right now, man.
Good, man. Good. You're on top of the world.
Nearly two decades in, man, just like Graves said, hats off to you. And you know, Monday night was really cool for me sitting as a fan, not a part of Raw, to sit there and go, whoa, what a moment. So that was awesome, and congratulations.
Yeah, man. I appreciate it. And one other thing, where is Brock? Is anybody saying anything about that? That's like, now maybe I have something you want.
You know. Last time you talked about him here on ATB, it caught fire on interwebs. We are happy to throw that out into the collective consciousness of the world. Because still somewhere secretly in my back, but not so secretly, I said it last week.
Last week, yeah.
I'm still hoping for that one somewhere down the line. Yeah. I just hope for my own personal sake that Bobby, you hold on to the WWE Championship long enough to face Brock Lesnar, whether that's at WrestleMania or SummerSlam or in 2023.
On a
just
random
don't
Raw.
Don't deny me of that. Hell, I'll come to some high school gymnasium, even if neither of you are with WWE anymore. I'm ready.
I want to be under 50 before it happens.
Well, there it is. The ball is in Brock's court.
But man, it would be incredible for run a triple threat. That'd be a triple threat that I'd be interested in too.
Brock, Drew, and Lashley. It's a lot of beef in that ring.
Yeah. Somebody might not make it out of there.
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.